Today we're tackling an age-old question. Do you have to count calories in order to lose weight? The short answer is no. And today I've got four easy and practical alternatives. Coming right up. Hey Killer Bees, I'm Pahla B, your best middle-aged fitness friend. And true confession time, I actually don't like to count calories. And yet last year at age 50, I was able to successfully lose about 8 pounds. So how did I do it? And why do I normally recommend that you count calories? You guys, in my 5-0 method, which I have here on screen and in the description box below, I outline what I think of as the simplest way to lose weight. Eating the right number of calories every single day, drinking the right amount of water, getting enough sleep, exercising moderately, and managing your mindset. So yeah, I actually recommend that you count calories because it's incredibly simple. The information is everywhere and it's really easy to calculate because there are dozens, probably hundreds of apps that can help you with it. The only downside to counting calories is that word, calories. Sometimes the thought of counting calories is what can really trip us up. Let me tell you the four alternatives that you could try instead. And while we're talking about it, which one of these things do you think I did? Alternative number one is to count something else, like macros or points. Now, the pros on this one is that it's incredibly simple to do. A 5-minute Google search will get you everything you need to know for just about every kind of food you could possibly eat. Now, the cons are that you're actually still counting and probably still weighing and measuring as though you were counting calories. Alternative number two is to eat the same foods in the same portions every single day. Now, the pros on this one are that it's super simple. You make a decision once, you never have to figure something out on the fly, you always know what's coming next. The cons are that you're eating the same foods in the same portions every single day. Alternative number three is to eat to your hunger cues. The pros on this one is that this is a beautiful, loving way to give your body exactly what it needs when it needs it. The cons, however, is that there's actually a pretty sharp learning curve and your hunger isn't infallible. And here's what I mean by that. There's actually both a physiological and psychological component to hunger cues. So if you have been eating at noon every day for hundreds of years, then your body is going to send you hunger signals at noon, even if you just ate and don't actually need the energy. Or on the flip side of that, if you've actually been ignoring your hunger cues for 100 years, then your body might not even be producing those hunger signals anymore. Alternative number four is to use your hand to plan your meals. Now, I am not taking credit for this one. I totally got this from a place called Precision Nutrition, and I'll even hook you up with a link in the description box below so that you can see the work that they do. But here's what you do. At every single meal, you have a palm of protein. You have a fist of vegetables. You have a cupped hand of some kind of grain or carb, and you have a whole thumb of fat. Now, the pros on this one are pretty obvious. You don't really have to weigh or measure anything, and the tool that you would use to do such a thing is pretty handy. The cons on this one though are, what about casseroles, right? Like, it's totally easy if you're eating a plate that has like a chicken breast and a scoop of vegetables and rice with like a little bit of butter on it, but real world foods can get a little bit trickier. Okay, yes, I am gonna tell you which one I did, but first of all, let's talk about these alternatives. Did one of them sound like really appealing to you, or did they all still sound kind of tough? The thing is, all of these alternatives still have something in common, and that is that you need to pay attention to what you're eating. There is no way to sidestep the fact that paying attention and counting something is a mindset issue. This is something that you are going to need to tackle, and I'm going to ask you, why does it feel tough to do that? And that's a real question. I'm actually wholeheartedly encouraging you to get out your journal and ask yourself why it feels difficult to count. This is something that you're going to need to figure out on your way to successful weight loss. What do I do on my way to successful weight loss? If you guessed that I ate the same things in the same portions every single day, you are absolutely correct. For reals! You guys, I actually found this to be incredibly simple and kind of soothing. I knew exactly what I was gonna eat every single day for 6 months. And there was actually a lot more variety to it than you might think. If you'd like to know exactly what I ate every single day, check out this video right here, and I'll see you over there.